Welcome on this session from the Benelux Business Club. Thank you very much for joining us today again. Welcome, especially welcome to Mr. Ambassador from Belgium, Jean-François Branders. As I just heard, it's your first meeting that you join with the Benelux Business Club, and I'm very happy that you are here today. And I hope it will be an inspiring event, which will lead to more occasions in the nearby future. Next to that, I also want to thank the Hilton Hotel. Remy, thank you very much for having us here today and giving us the opportunity to host this event. Very well appreciated. And of course, everybody being present today, we're going to talk about a very interesting topic. And we have here sitting on the right-hand side, André Boom. He's a managing partner of EHRM Vision, and he is rolling out the TMA concept, working in human capital. And I've heard you're doing a great job, and you're going to enlighten us today what it is all about when it comes to sense and nonsense in competence management. Well, I'm looking forward to that, to finally understand the answers to that question. So André, can I ask you to take it from here?
Thank you. Thank you, Roon, for offering me this platform. I would like to have an interactive session with you about the topic competence management, and specifically on the issue of where does it make sense and where does it become nonsense. And that is a very thin line. And I want to use that parabolic, or even it's a little bit diabolic, and a contradiction in the whole phenomenon. And what I do is I advise and consult a lot of companies in implementing competence management. And as you probably will experience yourself, there is hardly any company that is not using competence management. And I'm not only saying companies, but also organizational or governmental organizations. And what do we define as competence management or a competence? Are you using, Mr. Ambassador, in your governmental organization competence management?
Well, I suppose we try to recruit competent people, but why call it competence management? I think it's always been done, even before you invented the words.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Sometimes I'm saying there's a lot of literature and a lot of knowledge you can search on the internet. Just type in competence management on the internet and. You know, probably your computer cannot even handle it, that amount of information. But what is it actually about? And actually, it is not a new phenomenon. It is as old as people are living.
Do you think it has also to do with fashion? I mean, there are certain times, there are keywords which are all the time you see, there are certain keywords that are repeated all the time. People, at a certain time, you have to have social competence. Another time, they are not talking about that. They're talking that you should be very independent. Another time, you should,
Of course, it's a fashionable world. There's always a hype. All of a sudden, there's a focus. And then we create a new market by using new names. Because if I'm asking, what is the difference between performance management or competence management or talent management? What's the difference? It's just a name. Because basically it's still about finding out what people can add as a value in a certain kind of environment and giving people the guidelines. So yeah, of course, that is the marketing tool. This is what it's all about, because that's making the difference in our working environment. It is your professional behavior. Why is behavior caused?
Motivation, skills.
Yeah. For example, skills or motivation. Is there more?
Personality.
Is there more?
Experience.
Skills and experience.
Creativity.
Creativity. Is that a skill or a personality trait?
More personality.
Yeah. Creativity. Crea. It has to do with your, if you're profiling, it has to do with your market. It has to do with your settings. It has to do with the results. And it has to do with the facilities. Then you start profiling one job.
André, maybe it's a good idea
due to the time limit, we continue our questions and talk at the bar.
That's my lack of competence. I can never track time.
But anyway, I would like to thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much. Because you definitely planted some seeds when it comes to sense and nonsense in terms of competency management. For me, definitely, this is something that I could talk for hours about. It's nice to see the different approaches that you give. And I also would like to give the advice, what André said. The link that we're going to put on the website is definitely absolutely interesting to dig into and to try and to see what it is all about and how it looks in practice. We are a little bit short of time, so I would like to stop here and have a drink at the bar around the corner, where we have the opportunity to network and talk with each other and talk with André about what it's all about and even more. So if you have your questions, let's do so. So André, thank you very much again. I would like to give you a hand for let's go outside, or let's go over the other room. Thank you.